Hello guys, Eduardo Ferraz from CTI USA. You already know what I'm going to say, right? If you're new here, click on this button, subscribe on our channel. Don't forget to give your like, it's very important to us. And be part of our family. Every Friday we go live, we have our town hall show. We bring you guys here news about the cruise industry, what's going on, the opportunities, you know, the returning of the cruise ships. The cruise industry, guys, is ready to take off like an airplane. So you have to be part of that. So today's video, I came here and I'm going to talk to you guys about room attendant. You wanna know more about this position? You wanna know what it takes to work on a ship as a room attendant or cabin steward, which is, that's the job you're gonna do there. You're gonna clean room when you are on the land, right? Work in the hotels, resort. But when you go into the ship, you go clean cabin. Stay tuned, watch this video, be part of our family. If you haven't watched all the positions that we had here, I already spoke about housekeeping, hotel steward, laundry attendant, and now I'm going to talk about room attendant, which is cabin steward. So cabin steward, it's a position really nice to work on the ship. Why? Because you're going to be able to interact with guests. Of course, you're going to make a lot of money through tips, because people are going to give tips to you as well as you guys do a good job. And why not pursue this career? Why not start your career as a cabin steward? But to go to the ship as a cabin steward, we require for you some experience. Why? Because most people, even if they work as a cabin steward on a lane, like in a hotel or resort, when they go to the ship, they start on the housekeeping department, like as a hotel steward, cleaning like the public area, like cleaning elevators, cleaning restrooms, cleaning things that everybody uses into the ship. But to clean cabins is one step above. And I'm going to tell you guys what it takes if you want to straight start your career as a cabin steward. And believe me, you will require a lot of experience from that. So, cabin steward, room attendant, knock the door 3 times. Oh, nobody answer. Let me open very slow, check nobody's here, right? So nobody's here. Open the shades, let the sun shine in your face, start to do all the procedure that you guys already know. So guys, this is something that most of you guys learn when you go to hospitality school. You guys learn when you start your career on the hospitality industry, work in a hotel, in a resort. And everything depends in which level are you working right now, or you have worked before. If you expose yourself in a 5-star, 6-star hotel, of course, you guys is going to know more about quality, about standards, about time, and about be efficient in your job or what you do. So when you're going to apply to work as a cabin steward, most of the time you're going to apply, for example, let's say about Carnival, we're going to apply as a hotel steward. And just few people, why I say few, because it's not everybody that have what it takes to start their career on the ship straight as assistant cabin steward. Unless if you already have cruise ship experience, or maybe you work in a really nice hotel for a long time, like Grand Hyatt or any other 5-star hotel, you know, where give you a good exposure. But we know that this position requires for you a lot of friendship. Like, you need to be friendly. You need to be sourceful. You need to be someone who speak a really good English. As I mentioned, you guys is going to be in touch with the guests many times. When you knock the door 3 times, the room won't be empty. So any guests are gonna come talk to you. And as they talk to you, how you approach that, how you grading the guests, how you talk to them, do you call them by their name? You know, you're the type of person that can go outside the box sometimes and say a few words. Do you understand all the areas of the ship in case if the guest asks you, so today I want to go to that pool, or today I want to go to that movie theater. So can you explain to them with clear English how they can get there? So can you explain to them dining room areas, you know, restaurant areas, everything on the ship? Do you know what it is? Can you be that person who is going to be resourceful, who is going to take that responsibility and not only clean the room, but also be the person who is going to guide the guest in case he needed it? And of course, if you don't know, you're gonna find someone who knows, but at least you're gonna get that done. Working this position, guys, as I mentioned, is really cool, and that's why you usually, when people go to the ship, they start one step below, like cleaning public areas. Doesn't mean they cannot clean a cabin. Yes, they can, but as I mentioned to you, when you work on the ship, guys, you need to be resourceful. You need to understand the ship. You need to understand names. It's things that you are going to learn only when you get on the ship. And many times, even for those people who have experience on a five-star hotel for a long time, you know, they might be leading a team who is cleaning like 20, 100, 200 rooms per day. Even if they have that experience, sometimes when they start to work on a ship, they start to work as a hotel steward, hotel utility. Why? Because they need to understand the environment for a while, at least for 3 months, 6 months. It depends how long is going to be your probation time. Probation time is the time that you need it in order to understand all the protocols on the ship, understand about safety, understand about your duty, and of course, get experience enough to be exposed in front of the guests and do well. So, guy, working this position here, I have some notes that I have put together. And of course, it's not only knock the door 3 times, you guys must know the chemicals that you use. You know, you guys must understand the standards that the company that you are going to work for, so you can deliver your job properly, right? It's not only try to clean the room as fast as you can. Why? Because let's say if you have 30 minutes to clean a room, with 30 minutes you're gonna clean a room with a quality. But if I give you 15 minutes to clean a room, it's not gonna be that quality again. And no matter how good you are, because it's certain checks and double checks that you have to jump in order to finish your duty early, like rather than 30 minutes, 15 minutes. So each company, each cruise line that you guys are gonna work is going to give you guys enough time to clean the room properly. And of course, you need to be efficient, and at the same time, you need to be fast, correct? Because maybe someday one of your fellows, they are sick, and you have to cover them. So if you clean 2 or 3 more rooms, and then you offer 2 or 3 more rooms, at the very end, everything gonna be fine. Most of you guys know that before you start your day, you're gonna have a meeting with your supervisor, right? Or someone who is in charge of that department on that area you guys are cleaning, or into the ship, or in a hotel, in your rep, on your resort. So being on that meeting, you guys have to observe what that guidance is going to help you solve a problem that he's facing. Let's say the hotel is receiving a lot of complaints about the bathroom is not well cleaned. Probably your supervisor is going to say, guys, I need you guys to spend more time on the bathroom. I want you guys to make that bathroom as clean as it's impossible. You make more than the best of you can. Work crazily in order to get that super clean. So, and when your supervisor give you guys a guidance and tell you to focus on something, why? It's because he received, complaints from the guests that go to the front desk and say, listen, my bathroom is not clean, my towers is not that wide that I was expecting. So things like that is going to tell the supervisor, which will tell you guys, and you are going to pay attention in order to solve that problem. So every morning, usually you guys have meeting, and your supervisor is going to guide you what you guys have to pay attention on. Like, oh, today we are low in stuff here. We have less people working. So I need you guys work hard and then try to do as fast as possible so we can cover and then get that done. Your job is extremely important on the housekeeping department because you guys have to make the bed, have to make sure the bed is really clean, is well made. The bathroom, the toilet have to be really clean. The room needs to smell good, right? And of course, many of your supervisors, many people that work, they're going to help you also double check like TV, coffee machine, refrigerator, check if these things is working, even if it's not your duty to fix, but if it's not working well, you're gonna let them know and then they're gonna fix before the guests walk in. So guys, this position is really good, but the most important thing you must have is your English. Communication is the key of success. You have to communicate really good. Your personality has to shine. You have to show your personality. You have to put yourself in a situation that no matter what happens, you're gonna be able to handle. Your personality is gonna help you that because you're gonna have that feeling and understand when you have to say something and when you cannot say something or when you have to act. So you're gonna experience, you'll give that. So that's why experience is important as well. And if you work for a high standard 5 or 6 star hotel, you're gonna be much, much better. Why? Because you might start to work your career on a 5-6 star cruise line. But if you don't have that level yet, you might start to work for a major cruise line which has a lot of ships, but they are more willing to invest in. If they're willing to invest in you, of course, you have to start one position below in order to get experience enough to be exposed and then go ahead and then fulfill your duty as assistant cabin steward, and goes way above. So guys, understand, to work on a ship, you need an agent. You need a company who is going to help you get there. As we all know, it's a lot of people out there trying to get your attention and then sell you something that doesn't exist, or maybe get your money and don't send you anywhere. So you have to be careful with that. You have to be careful with scams. So your country, your government, he, you know, her, whoever is running your country, the main power of your country, they have laws, they have labor laws. And those labor laws is to ensure that you guys are going to receive the minimum so you guys be able to survive, so be able to have condition to work properly. And when someone take you from your country and send you to work overseas or any other country, that person need to understand that whoever is hiring you, whoever is giving you the job, need to follow the labor law condition from your country when they are hiring you. For example, people work overseas, working here for Carnival, for work for Virgin, work for Royal Caribbean. They all, and I'm not saying just few, they all have an agent. Why? Because this cruise line, they work with agents. They work with agents in Indonesia. For example, Carnival work with CTI. And as you guys come to CTI, CTI already work closely with your government. When I say work with the government, means we work, follow the government laws, follow the government labor law, and understand all the protocols and all the license that we need to have in order to send someone overseas and work legally. So all these things might be like, oh my God, I'm getting confused. You don't have to get confused. Just look for illegal agents. And if you don't have illegal agents, I'm gonna leave a video right here, right at the end of this video, so you guys can understand a little bit more about legal agents, understand about MLC, which is stand to give you guys a better condition, to give you guys the minimum, so you can, when you work on a ship, guys, you have some rights, you have things that you have to do, but you have rights as well. And an organization that's going to stand for you, that's going to protect you in case if something different happen. So keep in mind, knowledge is extremely important, and you have to know what's in your side and what is going to help you get there. Do not try to do yourself. Look for an agent, right? The agents might end up giving you guys opportunity to prepare documentation, might end up give you guys opportunity to fill your job application and things like that, rather than you try to do on your own and then someone disappear with your resume, disappear with your documents, disappear with your money, and then you get frustrated and believe that work on a ship is not something real. It is real. You can work on a ship, but you have to do the proper way. So the link will be here. The link, no, the video will be here. You guys can click and then you guys can watch, you know, and enjoy and understand that this is extremely important. So for those that want to work on a ship as a cabin steward, as a room attendant, so we have a link here. You can apply for a job. You can drop your resume. Our team is going to check. And then if you have what it takes, guys, you're going to be part of our family. And as the opportunity comes up, we're going to contact you, and then we're going to bring you here, present you to the cruise line. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give your like and engage. Put your comment here. Where are you working right now? What's your position? Have you worked on a ship? Not? So put your comment here. Let me know who you are.